Good afternoon, King of Avalon. This is Night 10, coming to you with a video that will take a look at the new equipment that's coming out with whatever limited information we have. First and foremost, if you haven't already, please subscribe, like, comment, and share. Help me on my journey to getting 1,000 subs. Once I do get 1,000 subs, I'll do a little giveaway of just some small Google Play gift cards as a tiny token of my thanks. And for those of you that already subscribed and comment always, I appreciate your support. Okay, so let me get into this. I made this chart in a couple videos ago, and I want you to keep in mind the concept of what's needed to forge the Flamebringer Ice Lord. Steel, basic mats, and rare mats. So this pattern of each type of equipment requiring two types of basic mats, two types of rare mats will be repeated in the Redeemer equipment. You will also need steel. Okay. The other thing, as you know, with Flamebringer or Ice Lord or Deathseeker, we needed scrolls, right? Or frags. Well, we needed scrolls and we needed 100 frags to forge one scroll. This concept of scrolls will no longer be applicable, and they replace it with these called ingots. Now, same idea. You need 100 ingots to forge the Redeemer equipment. Okay, so with that in mind, I want you to keep in mind this number. 216 rare mats. And about 180,000 basic mats for each piece of equipment. Whether it's, there's always going to be two types, 90,000. So 180,000 basic mats, 36 basic mats for each equipment. Okay. Now, right now, to forge Flamebringer, zero, sword, 1.4 million steel, 90k cerasite, 90k pine, so 180k basic mats, 36 rare mats. Ice Lord, 570k steel, 72,000 basic mats, and 14 rare mats. Now, for those of you that don't have Flamebringer or Ice Lord, or Deathseeker, or any equipment. Again, the concept of scrolls is out the door, replacing with ingots. But one thing I want to point out really quickly is that the basic mats requirements are the same. Okay? The rare mat requirements are going to be the same. The steel has increased. 1.7 million steel. Now, it's not going to break you. Right? Before it was 1.4 for the Flamebringer sword, or any Flamebringer equipment. Now it's 1.7. mil, 300k more. Before, 570k steel, now 696. Everything's the same except you're going to need more steel. So keep that in mind if you plan on upgrading Ice Lord or Flamebringer once the update comes out. So you should definitely upgrade your Ice Lord and Flamebringer now. I'm joking. Please don't do that. Yes, you're going to need more steel after the update, but you know what? I got a feeling the cost of everything will drop as it always does. So no, don't go out and forging your equipment now simply because of the fact it's going to need a little more steel. Steel these days is a lot easier to get. So hold on that. That's my recommendation. Okay, so let's get into the Redeemer. As you can see here in my beta, I've already forged base level battle axe. What I want to talk about is what is needed to forge a basic Redeemer equipment. You're going to need steel. A lot of it. 7 million. 100 of those Redeemer ingots. 360k of each basic mat, of which there are two types needed for each equipment. 720,000 basic mats. Let me go back here. 180,000. 180,000. Oh, no, wrong one. Okay, 180,000, 720,000. 180,000, 720,000. Okay. Rare mats, 144 to forge the Redeemer plate or base level, any Redeemer equipment. All right, let me go back here. And what was it here? 36 rare mats. 36 rare mats, and 144. Okay, so things are getting pretty exciting, right? Forging 242 hours. That's a lot of days. Okay, so to forge any piece of Redeemer equipment, this is what you need. 7 million steel, 720K combined basic mat, and 144 rare mats. So let's look at the battle axe, because I've already forged to base level 0. Stats aren't bad. I mean, it's not bad. I'm not going to lie about that, but I don't know the cost benefit ratio, because we don't know what the cost of packs. All I know, it's going to be buttload of expensive. That's guaranteed. Now, one thing I have to give to Koa is I do like the interface. I like this. I think it's an improvement. You can see all your equipment in one shot. Click Flamebringer, click Ice Lord, and you can see what you got. So they've consolidated that. I give them kudos for that. Smith's Mark, same thing. We knew this even before they brought out Flamebringer. They did announce that the concept of Smith's Mark would carry on, and it has, and Smith's Mark carries all the damage benefits. Okay, that's that. Bonus benefits, enhancement stats. Enhance the max level to unlock enchantment will increase the stats benefits of this equipment. And I'll talk about this later, because you can enhance a particular piece of equipment, like I have for the sword. It's plus 5 right now with the battle axe. And I'll talk about what that enhancement benefit is. All right. So to go from 0 to 1, what do we need? 11 million steel. And I'm sure that comma is not incorrect. There's probably a couple more zeros after that. 11 million steel, 40,000 essence. 1 to 2. 17 or 18 million steel, 60,000 essence. 2 to 3. 20, almost 24 million steel and 80,000 essence. 3 to 4. Almost 30 million steel and 100,000 essence. These are scary numbers. Now I have this screenshot here because to talk about what you get for enhancing from 0 to 1, 1 to 2. In the case of the Battle Axe, Redeemer Battle Axe, you're getting an additional plus 8.7% cav attack, bow attack, 9.7% troop defense, plus 5.8%, 18.4% in infantry attack. So these jumps or increases in power are similar from 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3. Similar with what's happening now. Okay, how to show that. Now, 4 to 5, 35 million steel and 120,000 essence, dragon essence. A lot. Okay, so I want to talk about this guy here, Enchant. Because my Redeemer Battle Axe is plus 5, I can enchant it now. And so what you do is, when you click enchant, you're going to need these certain types of flasks. And I'll show you what it looks like. And I enhanced it. So I got plus 80,000 power, because my troop health buff was increased by 5.32%. Now this is completely random, and it's interesting because you could go backwards. And what you need are these guys here. 30 of these enchantment consumption little red flasks. Okay, so it looks like for the battle axe, there is a maximum percentage that the enchantment can give you. For example, 77.55% infantry attack, 77.55 cav attack, 77.5 bowman health, 79.88% troop health. So far with that first enhancement, I've used up 5.32% of that 79.88%. Now, and I did it again. I got plus 2.66%. Great. Using up those enchantment flasks. I did it again. And I got a negative. Lost 40,000 power because, interesting enough, what I gained in that 2.66%, I lost again. So you see, it doesn't take away from your base stats. It takes away from the enchantment stats. And I did it again. Minus 5.32%. I lost 80,000 power. So you're using these flasks, which I'm sure you're going to have to buy, and you might lose power. I don't know. I'm kind of not too happy about what they did with that. You know, I could understand maybe varying the increase in percentage, but not taken away. I mean, why should it take away power? That's an interesting concept to me. Anyhow, So again, you're going to need these red flasks to increase your enchant or to play the enchantment game. And again, no more scrolls. You're going to need 100 of these Redeemer Plate ingots, 100 Flamebringer ingots, Ice Lord ingots, and the color will be associated with the color of the equipment. Okay. And yeah, I hope that you found this informative, and we're still kind of operating in a black box. We can't really look at it in context because we don't know the base costs for the packs, but I can guarantee you it's going to be a lot. Pretty expensive. So anyhow, I hope all of you are well. You know, summary, gonna take a lot of materials. Recommendation, don't do anything until the new update comes out. If you want to do Ice Lord or Flamebringer, I'd wait. You're gonna need some more steel. That's kind of the negative result of the new upgrade, but I'm sure the cost of everything will go down. So wait, don't upgrade. With that, if you haven't already, please like, subscribe. If you could, encourage your Alliance members to subscribe to my channel. I'd greatly appreciate it. And with that, we'll call it a day. Thanks so much.